Let me ask you a question, students. Have you ever been fighting with your wife about the mortgage she took out, invested it into some crypto that some YouTuber told you to do, lost everything, had her act out, being a little cold, a little disappointed in you? Let me ask you this. Have you ever called her a tsundere as she walked out the front door with her bags and your kids, just with a look of disgust and confusion? Well, that's because she just doesn't understand what a tsundere is. So that's what we're gonna go over today, is to enlighten these people on what a dere is. Deres. Now, Blake, I think this might be really out of your depth for this one. You're a tsundere. What do you think being a tsundere means?
Well, it sounds like you're like kind of like they're not being good to you. So it's kind of like a derogatory word, I feel like maybe calling them like a B word, maybe, you know?
Oh, like a bitch.
Yeah.
There is a particular way of describing certain characters. I guess you can describe it simply as a character type. Specifically, when it comes to romance, what does it even mean? Dere. It comes from a Japanese word, dere dere. Describe someone that is showing like affection. Just generally speaking, it's like love, affection. Deres are kind of like the potato chip of anime characters. Not only do we love potato chips, but there's many different flavors. I like Takis.
I like
They make my stomach hurt though.
the texture of Takis,
They're
but
really spicy.
dude, yeah, I mean,
And they make my stomach hurt a
they are
lot.
hard to digest,
Oh
my friend.
yes, they are. There are common chip flavors. Cheddar, barbecue, sour cream and onion. Very similar to potato chips. There are also common types of deres. The cheddar of deres, maybe tsundere. But there's also more obscure flavors. You ever see a Pringle and it's like Italian guacamole pizza or something? And similar to these obscure flavors of chips, there's also more obscure types of deres. Okay, tsundere, an abrasive personality, but actually has a soft side underneath. The combative exterior, very simply put. Someone who seems maybe harsh or mean, but actually deep down they hold affection. Maybe they're sweet, maybe they're more caring. Common thing associated with tsundere is the phrase, "It's not like I like you or anything, but baka."
The sussy baka? That's
Perhaps a sussy baka. They feign a type of dislike when really they're actually like quite lovey-dovey. A prime example of a tsundere would be Cindy from Jimmy Neutron. Remember Cindy from Jimmy Neutron? Remember how she acted? Always mean to
Always tough.
Jimmy. But she was kind of into him, actually. That's the truth. You have a grasp on like this character, someone who's like kind of
Kind of
mean.
like tough.
It's kind of like, remember going back to school when you're like really young, you kind of pick on the people you like or you get picked on, right? Yandere. Yandere. What do you think yandere is?
Yawn. Can't even to yawn, you know, maybe they're tired. So like tired love. So yawn, you
So what
know.
would that person be like? They're just
They're
sleepy.
just they're like just think of like a koala bear, right? They're just
Okay.
yeah.
All right. Always thinking about the animals, Blake. I see. But no, yandere, affection eventually turns into a desire to inflict harm
Oh
or
God.
other extreme brutalities as an outlet for their affection, perhaps even murder.
Oh God.
They want to hurt you. They want to kill you, maybe even.
Yikes.
As a form of showing their love. They just love you so much. They just need to like 47 backstabs.
That's
My fucking money. No one else can have you.
scary. That's
It is scary. Yes. Yes.
I don't like this one at all. Tsundere, I was behind, but this one, I'm like, ooh, you know? Okay, so it's somebody that wants to kill you because they are obsessed with you,
They're
basically.
so obsessed
So
with you.
obsessed with you.
You know who I'm about to draw. I think the quintessential yandere is Yuno Gasai from Mirai Nikki, which that is a what, dude. Blake, have you ever seen an anime called Future Diary?
No, never even heard of anything you just said.
Actually, really good. It's called My Future Diary or The Future Diary. And this is a character from it. Her name is Yuno. And yeah, she has so much affection for the main character. She wants him all to herself and it wants to, Who said Hillary Clinton? Shut the hell up. What are you even saying?
She's so obsessed, she wants
Yeah.
to kill. So, like, can the other person, if the other person got with somebody else, would they kill
Oh,
them?
yeah, they
Oh,
probably,
yeah. So
yeah.
she's this obsessed, she'll take out
Yeah.
anybody. This is some freak shit, man. I don't like this at all.
Yeah, no. Yeah, pretty freaky.
Yeah, this is freaky. Pretty freaky.
Dandere.
Dandere.
Dandere. Very basically, a dandere is someone who is shy, timid. Like they like someone and they're kind of like maybe reserved, they're a little shy, embarrassed maybe.
That's like a lot of people then. So a lot of people I feel like would be considered a dandere.
Yeah.
Kind of shy, too afraid to approach their crush.
Yep.
Okay, then, dude, that's shit, man. That's me, man.
Yeah, are you a dandere?
I'm a dandere, man.
I think a very obvious dandere is Hinata Hyuga from Naruto. Very shy, afraid to approach Naruto to express her love. But then the series ends, you know, they finally get together. Then she becomes a MILF. So this one's very similar. There's a little bit of a nuance here between this one and the one we just went over, which would be dandere. But this is kudere. What do you think a kudere would be like?
Like maybe they're not as smart. Maybe they're a little bit on the dumber side, maybe.
Oh, interesting.
Not as intelligent?
Not quite, though. Ah. A kudere is a character that is calm and collected, does not express their emotions in a very sort of active manner. Now, it's very different. It doesn't mean that they're timid. It doesn't come from a place of shyness. It's more of a controlled type of personality. In my research, I think a very obvious example that you would be familiar with, Blake, is I picked Mikasa from Attack on Titan, right?
Yeah.
Calm, collected.
Yeah.
In this scenario here, when it comes to expressing their emotions, like, yes, they might be interested in someone, but they're going to control that. They're not going to let the emotions fly.
Yeah, I don't even remember ever her getting mad either. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. She's always like calm, timid, very relaxed. Even though she's about to kill 1,000, you know, titans, she seemed pretty chill about it. So
1,000 titans.
Mm-hmm.
One lover.
Mm.
Maybe could come across as like a little bit of a... Maybe.
Yeah. But I would too, though. Could you imagine her life? You having to do all that every day? I could play...
Being a...
Like being
Survey Corps member?
It would be terrible.
I'd be fine.
Yeah, right. What are the...
Yeah.
What was the other ones? The people that did the towns? They
No. That's pussy shit. No, I'd be like...
Bro, you'd be...
I would pretend, right? I would just be like... There'd be a lot of movement, and I'd be swinging my things. And in the chaos, they're gonna be like... Professor Lando, did you get that Titan? I'm like, I'm trying. But really, I keep a calculated distance between me and the Titan. I'm like, there's so many of them. And then I'd land and be like, oh, man, barely. Maybe one day I would let them get the leg calculated.
Mm-hmm.
I'd pretend. I'd cut it off myself, and I'd be like, I barely got away. Guess I'm going to have to retire in the city forever. The last type of most common main dere types that I have here is a dere dere. What is a dere dere?
I mean, that's just got to be, they're so, I mean, yandere, they were so obsessed. So I think dere dere is also like they're super obsessive, but maybe in like a healthier way.
Blake, very good use of context clues. Dere dere, it's a character that is very straightforward in their affection, openly loving towards their interest. So my example of a dere dere is Amy Rose from Sonic the Hedgehog. Amy Rose always lusting after Sonic, running around, Sonic!
Sonic gets all the ladies, doesn't he?
Oh, could you blame him? Giant fucking cop. Really fast.
Really fast, dude. Oh,
dude. Well, yeah, dere dere. Amy Rose is just very, you know, just very open.
Straightforward.
Like, I love you so much.
Yeah.
Not like I said about the potato chips, right? And we said, like, we just went over the cheddar cheeses, the barbecues, the sour cream and onions, the hot and spices. But there are, what about the crawfish hot pot flavor? Well, let's go over some more obscure dere types here. Now, I want to be clear. There are so many. There are some very obscure types. Can't go over all of them, but we'll go over some of the more, in my opinion, prominent ones.
So, like, this is where the creeps come out, right? The creeps come out to play.
I mean, nemui dere. Nemui dere. Okay. It's not impossible for you to guess this one.
So the first word in there is Nemo. So you know the movie Finding Nemo where they're trying to find
the lost. I'm familiar with the Finding Nemo movie.
So I'm assuming they like to play like, this is like a place where they like to play hide and go seek and they're trying to find
they're
trying to find their love.
They like to hide.
They like to hide, yeah, and then they like to find each other. It's like a love hide and go seek game.
Nemui dere is why I said you know this is because you said this. They're sleepy.
Oh, they're eepers. Wait, what does this one mean again?
They're sleepy.
Oh, sleepy. Oh, okay.
What are you talking about?
Long day, you know?
Okay, so my example of a Nemui dere, free ring. Actually, a perfect example. Very relevant example, a new example. Free ring, very sleepy. And again, people who are Nemui dere, characters that are Nemui dere, they're sleepy, but when they're awake, they show affection to the person, maybe trying to wake them up. If you remember in Frieren, there's a lot of these very endearing scenes where Fern is trying to wake Frieren up. And there's a lot of affection there. She's like, come on, wake up, wake up. Gotta get up. And she's kind of like sleeping, like, all right, I'm getting up, I'm getting up. To be fair, I think traditionally there are some characters that are like, necroleptics? What's the word for people that chronically sleeping? Narcoleptic? In the more traditional sense, a Nemui dere would be someone that literally is just asleep all the time, cannot be awake. But I thought Frieren was a very cute example because they always make a point that she's always sleepy, wants to sleep in all the time. Baka dere.
Baka, doesn't that mean like stupor? They're not as smart, right? So this has got to be somebody that they're just not as bright, man. They're in love, but they're like their IQs are on the lower side of the spectrum.
Indeed. Baka dere, someone who is a baka. They're dumb. They're an idiot. Someone who doesn't really know what's going on, like an airhead or something. Aqua from Konosuba. Not much to say, really. Baka dere, just like a dumb airheaded bitch.
Easy enough.
Yeah.
SpongeBob. That's what my brain is.
SpongeBob, yeah.
Yeah, it's got it. Yeah,
what do you think he's talking about when he says, I'm ready? Doro dere. Blake, what do you think? Doro dere.
Oh, dude, there's that anime, right? Called like Doro Idoro.
Doro Hedoro.
Oh, Doro Hedoro. I have no idea. Adore. Stubborn. Someone very, very stubborn. Stubborn-esque?
Kind of. So a Doro dere is someone who acts all lovey-dovey mm-hmm. towards their partner, but is actually full of contempt. And vitriolic thoughts.
Not good, man.
My example is my ex. Doro Derek, my ex. Wow. Fucking bitch. Yota Derek. I've also seen it. Yoi Dere. Yota Dere. A drunk.
Oh, they're drunk. Alcoholic?
Yep.
Ah.
Misato. From Neon Genesis Evangelion. God damn. Shinji, you lucky, lucky underage bastard. Misato.
Oh, that's the girl in the beginning, right?
You watch Neon Genesis Evangelion.
Jesus Christ.
You know this character, right? She's drinking.
Oh, bro, yeah. She's the one that's like trying to like kind of like get at him, sort of, right?
Yeah.
Like,
not quite milfy, kind of milfy. A pseudo milf. Best girl in Evangelion. What do you think, guys? Misato, hands down. Ray, I'm Team Ray. I used to be Team Asuka. So I see a lot of answers here, but the true answer is Ramael, the angel. Mdere. This is also called Masodere. Masochism. A character who enjoys being bullied or humiliated by their romantic partner or interest. They want to be forced into degrading acts and be submissive in a way. They want to be degraded. An example of a Masodere is me. Professor Lando. There's something to be said about anime versus real life here. And Dere is a perfect example where in anime, it's great, but in real life, not so great. What's an example of this besides Dere's? A Snaggletooth is an example of something that's way better in anime than IRL. This is Astolfo. Astolfo has a Snaggletooth. Which is this little anime, little like, it's this little cute little shark tooth. Only good in anime. Because if someone had a snaggle tooth in real life, protrudes out their face where when their mouth is closed,
it's fucking sticking out.
That's not so great. And derrys are like this because in anime terms, like yandere, that's a thing in anime. Someone who wants to murder you, right? Someone who wants to inflict pain, damage, right? In real life, that is called a felon. Premeditated murder. You can pick some of these derry types and we'll role play and act out so we can get an actual example of what a derry is.
Okay.
So tsundere.
Tsundere.
So like, Blake, I was wondering if you wanted to go on a date sometime.
Dude, are those really your glasses?
Oh, come on. What is this? Yeah. What do you mean?
I don't know, dude. They tough luck on you, man.
So let's just demonstrate one more.
Okay. Which one?
Let's do yandere. Ask me out on a date.
Professor, you want to go get some sushi?
Well, is it down the street?
Down the street, yeah, yeah.
All right, let's go. Let's show me.
Couple minutes?
Yeah,
okay, yeah, let's go.
Thank you so much to our Patreon supporters and a special shout out to the students shown here in detention. Check out my Patreon page for bonus content like extended footage, art, and behind the scenes updates. Thanks again.